everybody, this is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBytes.com. Today we're going to learn about America's 23rd president, Benjamin Harrison. Benjamin Harrison was born in Ohio on August 20th, 1833. His grandfather was William Henry Harrison, America's 9th president. While in school, Benjamin did very well in debates with other people. This helped him become a good public speaker later in life. After he finished school, Benjamin thought about becoming a preacher. However, he decided to go to college to become a lawyer instead. In 1852, he graduated from Miami University in Ohio. In 1853, Mr. Harrison married Caroline Scott, and they had 3 children together. Sadly, Caroline died shortly before her husband's presidency ended in 1892. Eventually, Mr. Harrison got married again to a woman named Mary Dimmock. During the Civil War, Mr. Harrison joined the Northern Army. He became a brigadier general for his many victories and bravery during the war. He led his soldiers into many different battles, including the Battle of Nashville. After the war, Mr. Harrison tried to become the governor of Indiana twice, but lost both times. However, in 1881, he was elected into the U.S. Senate. In 1888, the Republicans chose Mr. Harrison as their candidate for U.S. president. Mr. Harrison defeated President Grover Cleveland by a small margin. President Harrison is called the Billion Dollar President. This is because in 1 year during his presidency, he created a $1 billion spending budget. Some of the money went to the soldiers who had fought for the North during the Civil War. Another part of the money went to making America's Navy bigger and stronger. President Harrison also signed the McKinley Tariff of 1890. Which made countries pay more in taxes for supplies they were trading with America. Another law that President Harrison signed was the Land Revision Act of 1891. This allowed the president to set aside land for America's national parks. As a result, President Harrison was able to set aside land for Yellowstone National Park in Wyoming later in his presidency. Also, while Mr. Harrison was president, 6 more states were added to America. North Dakota, South Dakota, Wyoming, Montana, Washington, and Idaho. In 1892, Mr. Harrison ran for president again, but this time lost to Grover Cleveland. So he went back home to Indiana and wrote 2 books, This Country of Ours and Views of an Ex-President. During this time, Mr. Harrison gave many speeches all over the country and also worked for Presidents Cleveland and McKinley. Benjamin Harrison died of pneumonia on March 13, 1901, in Indianapolis, Indiana. He was 67 years old. An interesting fun fact is that during Benjamin Harrison's presidency, light bulbs were installed in the White House for the very first time. One time, President Harrison got shocked by one, and after that, he and his wife were always afraid of the lights. This is Solomon Schmidt from HistoryBytes.com, and until next time, go learn your history!